for private education. So this requires a thorough overhauling immediately, technical education, because you know this gives lot of skills and this gives employment opportunities. And according to a survey that is being made at All India level, you know, as far as BTech graduates are concerned, 11% of the engineering graduates are employable. Only 11%. So out of every 100 engineering graduates produced, only 11 fellows are employable. Remaining 89 fellows are useless. They are thrown out in the market. They are working in call centers. And even they are ready for right to sure. I mean, somebody has pointed out they are ready to work as even constables and SIs. The BTech graduate and they are ready to do any type of job. Why should we produce?
They also
criminals. So yes, we have seen in the TV. So therefore, we should first of all we have to have a thorough look about technical education. Because what type of graduates we are producing, and this is because of privatization. Privatization without proper regulation. And here, excuse me, that as far as the functioning of Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education is concerned, it is reduced only to SETS conducting agency, that's all. Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education, what it is doing is, it is conducting only MSET, LASET, PSET, this EdSET, this SET, that SET, that's all. It has given examination conducting agency rather than regulating agency. Actually, its function is to coordinate higher education, both the college education and also university education in the state. And it should function effectively on those lines. But instead of regulation, it is only conducting examination. And that's why the entire higher education is reduced only to one thing, that is admissions and examinations. The entire higher education. And what is happening in between admission and examination, nobody is bothered. So therefore, now we have to bother about what is happening in between. Because, you know, for 6 months in a year, we go on conducting exams and also admissions. And after that, you know, semester comes near, you know, so you vomit something in the classroom and that fellow writes something, you give very easy marks very easily to the students. And everybody says, I am a first class, I am. But how many number of classes are taken? What is the quality of teachers that are, there in the classroom? Nobody is bothered about this. So this is one disturbing aspect. Now the state council should not be reduced into SETS conducting agency and spinning money out of these SETS. They are spending a lot of money. And if you see, there are a lot of controversies going on about the fixed deposits there in the case of AP State Council of Higher Education. Crores of fixed deposits are there. I think there will be a controversy shortly about that also. How to distribute these fixed deposits between Telangana and Andhra.
So, around
100 crores, I am telling. But if you look at government colleges, in a very pathetic situation, I am visiting so many aided and also government degree colleges because I am trying to give some lectures on the quality of education. Now, on quality issues, I am working out. I go very frequently in the NAC peer teams and I am very much interested in the gradation of these colleges. So I am helping many degree colleges in Telangana state. So when I went to aided colleges and also government colleges, infrastructure facilities are very poor. And in the case of just now, our Muthiyamreddy was saying about structure of higher education in Andhra Pradesh. We have central universities, state universities, private universities, deemed to be universities. And in colleges, we have government colleges, aided colleges, and also totally unaided colleges. So government colleges, they're in a very pathetic stage. Number one, faculty shortage. Not only in the case of government colleges, in university-funded universities, state universities, and even central universities also, faculty shortage is a very big issue now. Lot of discussion is going on at a national level, and debate is going on about faculty shortage in the universities. On the one hand, we are talking about quality. On the other hand, there is a faculty shortage. How can you improve quality of education without teachers? You might have got a lot of technological developments and ICT introduction in the case of education, but without teachers and his performance in the classroom, you cannot create any impact on the students. So that's why, you know, this faculty shortage issue has to be taken up very seriously, especially Telangana also. And, you know, out of all the universities, state universities dominate the entire universities. Private universities hardly 100 at a national level. Central universities are 10%. But 50% of the universities are only state government universities. In all the states put together, 50%. And more than 50% faculty shortage is there in the case of all these universities, so-called central and also state universities. And in government colleges, if you try to take into account, 70% of the faculty shortage is there in government colleges. You know, when I just 1 week back, I went to one government college for giving a lecture on quality issues. You know, I asked them, what is the sanction strength? Sanction strength in that particular college is around 40. And only 16 teachers are permanent and the remaining are part-timers and contract. I think the same is the fate of all the government colleges in the case of the state. Now we are trying to think of establishing new colleges as the new government has come and also new universities. Except Adilabad and Karimnagar, almost all the districts have got universities. Adilabad, shortly they are going to start. And Warangal, one more university, that is health university, is coming up. And I think Khammam is not having any university as on today, but in future they may start. But out of, you know, the whatever the number of universities are there, more than a dozen universities are there, around 14 to 15 are there, including central universities. 50% of the universities are concentrated only in Hyderabad, as pointed out by, you know, Shiva Reddy. And the remaining 50% are located in districts. That's why I'm trying to say is that in future, whatever the institutions that are going to be established, they have to be established in district headquarters, but not in Hyderabad. Hyderabad has developed. But after development of other districts, let us try to concentrate on Hyderabad. That's a deconcentrate. There should be a moratorium on establishment of new universities and colleges in Hyderabad, around Hyderabad. And let us, Karimnagar, Mahabubnagar, I mean Adilabad, and then Khammam, and then Warangal, these districts ought to be taken on priority basis as far as higher education is concerned. Because higher education is a critical input in the process of development. That, you know, the state government has to know. But unfortunately, there is a disturbing scenario in Telangana when compared to Andhra Pradesh. Because there are 7 universities now without vice chancellors for the past 7 to 8 months. So it is just like headless family. If a university is without vice chancellor, it is just like not having a family head. You know the discipline of the children and the family without the head of the family. That is what is happening. And as rightly pointed out by Professor Muthiam Reddy, the functions of the universities are two. As far as colleges are concerned, only teaching is the function, awarding the degree and sending them out. But as far as universities are concerned, teaching and research, both of them are important functions. Teaching can be done by a degree college or a PG college, but research, universities are supposed to be knowledge producing centers. That is the difference between a college and a university. Universities are supposed to be knowledge producing centers. Therefore, research has taken a back seat in the universities and nobody is bothered about research. If you take the number of papers published and the type of thesis that are being produced in the case of universities, very, very horrible. And I don't want to look into that. A lot of degeneration has taken place with regard to the quality of publications and also the research that is taking place. So AP State Council, instead of, you know, concentrating on sets, they have to concentrate on improvement of quality of teaching and also improvement of research, also quality research. And then a quality mechanism has to be established as a part of State Council of Higher Education to see that quality regulation takes place of the entire higher education, especially the universities. And as far as research scholars are concerned, at present, every university is conducting entrance and taking the scholars. You know, 1,000 scholars are taken for research. What is this nonsense that is taking place? Are they having aptitude? They are joining for the sake of getting a seat in the hostel and preparing as rightly pointed out for these competitive examinations rather than contributing something to the growth of knowledge in the case of that particular subject. So we have to reverse this trend. For that, AP State Council, Telangana State Council of Higher Education has to concentrate on taking the research scholars on the basis of either Telangana set or NET. University should not be given the power to conduct entrance to make admissions, because what is under the pressure, what vice chancellor is doing, what Usmani and Kaak University vice chancellor did is that try to reduce the qualifying marks, increase the number of students as far as research is concerned. And what type of students we are taking? And under his supervisor, then instead of 6, 12, 9, 8, 9, 10, what is this? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. And they are also inviting other supervisors, other university supervisors they are recognizing. Retired supervisors also they are recognizing. So this is something nonsensical. We have to reverse this trend. Therefore, either NET should be made a qualification for, JRF should be made as a qualification for research, or, you know, AP set for entire state, only single agency, that is one AP state, the Telangana set has to be conducted. Only on the basis of that we have to take admissions by again advertising a different universities. This is one thing. And even for recruitment also, what we have to do is, we have to have TPPSC should not conduct the recruitment for universities. It is not, you know, this, as per the Universities Act, you know, they are not qualified to conduct, you know, university recruitment. Up to degree college they can conduct, but university recruitment has to take as per the act only university vice chancellors. But while appointing vice chancellor, you appoint a very, very competent fellow who has got administrative experience, who has got, you know, maturity in running the university as a vice chancellor, give him all powers. Because, you know, universities were running only with vice chancellors who are appointed below. But appoint vice chancellors of good quality, hand over the powers to them, then make recruitment compulsory. UGC has come out recently with an idea that if a university vice chancellor, that is central universities, if a university vice chancellor is not going to make recruitment in a particular time, they are going to de-link that university from funding. The state governments also should do it. And another issue is that governments are also starved of money, resource crunch. You know, earlier, you know, long back, this block grant is fixed for universities in the entire state of Telangana, this Andhra Pradesh. The same thing now they are falling for, you know, these states. Except to 5-10% rise, 15% rise, and Mucham Reddy Garu knows as the registrar, 10% rise or 20%. That is incremental block grant they are giving. This is something nonsensical. It's not incremental block grant. It should be need-based block grant. It should cover fully the non-teaching salaries and teaching salaries. That is what is a block grant. Then development grants they get from UGC. Development grants are not given by the states. Let us don't give development grants. If you want, you give some development grant. But the state must be in a position to this pay the salaries of non-teaching and teaching on the basis of the permanent teachers and also permanent these things. You try to fix the block grant and release it immediately. Quarterly grant they give. In the meanwhile, they do all nonsense, distance education, this, that, you know, they mobilize the funds from examination branch, they are paying the salaries. You see that the 50% gap is there in Usmani University between the black grant and the actual expenditure incurred on teacher salaries. The same thing is there in Kakatiya also. So this particular scenario has to be changed. At the national level itself, public expenditure on higher education at a very low level. Higher education is only 1.22%. And the entire education it is 3.5%. And higher education is only 1.22%. And Prime Minister, President of India says that none of the Indian universities figure in the top 200 universities. What is that you are giving? You are giving 1.22% of the GDP towards allocation to higher education. Now asking universities to compete with, you know, world universities, this is something nonsense. Without, you know, proper funding, you cannot develop the facilities of the universities and research cannot be improved. So this is another important point we have to take into account seriously. So I think I will come in the next round. Let us say, yeah. So thank you very much once again for giving me this opportunity.